Once again, as we continue to gather here for our Eucharist, once again, as is our custom, we ask, is anyone celebrating a birthday? Child of God is having a birthday. Sam, happy birthday, Sam. I'm always trying to inspire with their Greek Hebrew names. Is anyone celebrating an anniversary? Okay. Then once again, I ask your prayers. It seems like our list gets bigger, but so does that hunger and that craving for love and prayers for one another. So we once again remember Carol Bartlemy, Carol Mills, Sylvia Wilcox and her cousin Molly, Gina, Terry's granddaughter, so many that have had strokes and are asking for great healing again in their loved ones' lives. For Mary and Vincent, for Philip, Rob and Jason, for Fran and Carmen, Joe and Victor and Julie, for Arlene and Tim and Rick, Greg Grease and Anna, Tom, Jeanette Yunk, Marion, Eric Dunkel and his family, and Lisa, for Catherine and her baby, for Jeff Abbas, for Hannah and Keith, Steve and Mike, for Tara Linsmeyer, for Leo and Kyle Donlinger, we keep in prayer. And once again, that God willing, a little Elijah Vu may be found safe. We keep in prayer Amy Burns, who passed away, for Jim and Marilyn Burns' daughter, 54 years old. So we keep her in our prayers and the Burns family as well. For Matthew Walkner and Sherry Zimmerman, who celebrated the sacrament of marriage this morning, may their lives overflow with the joy of Christ. So we gather these prayers and so many more together as we gather here on this great feast of Trinity Sunday. So let us rise once again, greet your neighbor if you so desire, and we'll begin our worship formally today.
Good afternoon. Please face the center aisle and join us in singing 611, Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty, 611.
Oh,
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. Gathered together for our Eucharist once again this day, we gather to celebrate the only gift in life that matters, that our God is so deeply in love with us. And so it is we gather here to celebrate three persons in one God. We pause that we might be filled with all we need this day, especially with life and health and peace. You are God of the heavens and the earth, to whom we offer praise. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You are our hope, our salvation. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are the source of our eternal life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us all our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us sing God's praises. Let us pray. God our Father, who by sending into the world the word of truth and the spirit of sanctification, made known to the human race your wondrous mystery, grant us, we pray, that in professing the true faith, we may acknowledge the Trinity of eternal glory and adore your unity, powerful in majesty. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us be seated once again to be nourished by God's word. And for those who desire the text, it is on 1191.
A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses said to the people, "Ask now of the day of old, before your time. Ever since God created man upon the earth, ask from one end of the sky to the other. Did anything so great ever happen before? Was it ever heard of? Did a people ever hear the voice of God speaking from the midst of fire as you did and live? Or did any God venture to go and take the nation for himself from the midst of another nation by testings, by signs and wonders, by war, with strong hand and outstretched arm, and by great terrors, all of which the Lord your God did for you in Egypt before your very eyes? This is why you must now know and fix in your heart that the Lord is God in the heavens above and on earth below, and that there is no other. You must keep his statutes and commandments that I enjoin on you today, that you and your children after you may prosper, and that you may have long life on the land which the Lord your God is giving you forever." The word of the Lord.
speak of the glory of your reign and declare your mighty deeds. I will praise your name forever, my King and my God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, those who are led by the Spirit of God are sons of God. For you do not receive a spirit of slavery to fall back into fear, but you received a spirit of adoption, through whom we cry, Abba, Father. The Spirit himself bears witness with our spirit that we are children of God, and if children, then heirs, heirs of God and joint heirs with Christ, if only we suffer with him so that we may also be glorified with him. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. The 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain to which Jesus had ordered them. When they all saw him, they worshiped, but they doubted. Then Jesus approached and said to them, "All power in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you. And behold, I am with you always, until the end of the age." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
A word, there is a word in the gospel. You know, it's sometimes a word in the gospel that touches me, and you hear it year upon year upon year, and then all of a sudden it just sticks out at you. When they saw Jesus coming, they worshiped. And when it says they worshiped, they were down on their knees. They were maybe even flat. They were down. So they worshiped. They bowed down. But they doubted. And I think I've heard that for so many years. And I thought, they doubted. They doubted. But they didn't doubt Jesus. They did not doubt Jesus because they worshiped him. They knew it was the Lord. It was the Savior. It was the Christ. But they doubted. And in my heart, I just asked the question. I said, who did they doubt? And they doubted themselves. They doubted themselves. That Jesus says, when they saw him and they doubted, Jesus literally said, he drew near to them. So they saw him at a distance and said, oh gosh, here he comes. Full authority has been given to me both in heaven and on earth. And then he says this, go therefore and baptize all the nations in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Three persons, not three entities. We forget it's three persons. People were exiled over this language. Three persons in one God. Teach them to carry out everything I have commanded you. Can we? Think about that. No wonder they doubted, in a sense, themselves. Lord, we can't do what you do. And yet in John's gospel, what does Jesus say? You will do the deeds I do and greater ones than these. John chapter 14. You will do greater than these. Teach them to carry out everything I have commanded you. Holy Mother, that's a lot. I don't know who can. Everything? Teach them to carry out everything I have commanded you. How are we to do that in our lives? The answer lies in the very next sentence of Scripture. Know that I am with you always, even unto the end of the age. That the Holy Spirit is ever with us. It's the Holy Spirit who is with us and guiding us and sustaining us. It is the Holy Spirit who inspires us to do the deeds and the works that we do, because they are the works of Jesus and more. I don't know about you, but in my life there was a time that I've been through that I thought I had to do it all. I thought I had to do it all. And it's just not respecting the charisms of the local church and the community. I can't do it all. Teach them to carry out everything I have commanded you. So many teachers here, so many people with different ministries that are here. And know that I am with you. And we don't have to doubt. But we do have to say, Holy Spirit, take me. Grab me. Lift me. And that's for all of us. When we doubt that we really can't do something that the Lord is inspiring. The Lord might be inspiring you to take a step forward in your life to do something. Whatever it might be, the Lord might be inspiring you to simply say, spend more time with me. It's not just service. It's also growing in relationship with the Lord. And that may very well be. So I pray that that will be true for us. Finally, I have to quote Catherine of Siena. St. Catherine of Siena is a doctor of the church. Just, she has so much. If you ever want to read her, make sure you're awake when you do. But read her, because she's powerful. She's tremendous. And here's what she called the Trinity. And I want to leave you with this. Here's what she called the Trinity. And it always sticks with me, how she describes the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. And she says, who is the Father? The Father is the table. Well, who's the food on the table? You already know this, don't you? It's Jesus. But what struck me was her language. And then, who's the waiter who delivers the food? That's what she writes. Who's the waiter who delivers the food? You know that answer, don't you? It's the Holy Spirit. The Father is the table. Think about that as we come here. Sunday after Sunday, the Father is the table. The Son is the food that is served. And the food is transformed by the power of the Holy Spirit. That's the waiter who serves the food. Let your Spirit come upon these gifts to make them holy. Change them. Fascinating. She writes more than that, but that's good for tonight. How beautiful that it's just an image of the Trinity that sticks with me. And it's very personal here, and it has to do with when we gather right here, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Wow, three persons. We don't have to doubt. Know that I am with you always, says the Lord, even unto the end of the age. Go, therefore. What are we waiting for? Amen. Let us rise. And once again, let us return to the Nicene Creed. The Nicene Creed, let's profess our faith and proclaim, I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Good and gracious God, we turn to you with all our hearts. Hear your people's humble prayers that we place before you now.
That all who are baptized in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit live out our call to holiness, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those trusted with governance do so with diligence, exercising decisions based on mutual respect and honor, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who have died in their country's service be remembered with respect and gratitude, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Holy Spirit breathe freshness and renewal among all who are tired, discouraged, and downhearted, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those seeking God's will in their lives, that they open their hearts and minds to the possibility of religious life and lives of service, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
that the members of this faith community be a reflection of the Most Holy Trinity's life-giving vitality. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the faithful departed, for our deceased relatives and friends, for all the intentions in our prayer request book, and in particular for Les Grable, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Good and gracious God, hear the prayers that your family places before you. But bless, we pray, in a special way this day, all those lost in service to our country forever now, resting in your eternal peace. May the sounds of strife, the cries of battle, the wounds of war be calmed for all eternity in your loving and endless grace. Let these souls find rest at last, all souls, ever reminded that we who are left behind cherish their spirit, honor, and commitment, and that we send them our love. May we never forget the service they gave. Hear us, we pray, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us all be seated once again as our sacred altar table is clothed and prepared.
Please join us in singing 910, We Are Many Parts, 910.
Let us rise and pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept.
For the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Sanctify by this invocation of your name, we pray, O Lord our God, this oblation of our service, and by it make of us an eternal offering to you through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God. For with your only begotten Son and the Holy Spirit, you are one God, one Lord, not in the unity of a single person, but in a trinity of one substance. For what you have revealed to us of your glory, we believe equally of your Son and of the Holy Spirit, so that in the confessing of the true and eternal Godhead, you might be adored in what is proper to each person, their unity in substance, and their equality in majesty. For this is praised by angels and archangels, cherubim too, and seraphim, who never cease to cry out each day as with one voice they sing. You, therefore, Almighty Father, we bless through Jesus Christ, your Son, who comes in your name. He is the word that brings salvation. He is the hand you stretch out to sinners. He is the way that leads to your peace. When we ourselves are turned away from you, why you brought us back to be reconciled, O Lord, so that, converted at last to you, why we might love one another through your Son, whom for our sake you handed over to death, and now, celebrating the reconciliation Christ has brought us, we entreat you. Sanctify these gifts by the outpouring of your Spirit, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, whose command we fulfill when we celebrate these mysteries. For when about to give his life to set us free, as he reclined at supper, he himself took bread into his hands, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, on that same evening, he took the chalice of blessing in his hands, confessing your mercy, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this, celebrating therefore the memorial of the death and resurrection of your Son, who left us this pledge of his love. We offer you what you have bestowed on us, the sacrifice of perfect reconciliation. Holy Father, we humbly beseech you, accept us, together with your Son, and in this saving banquet, graciously endow us with his very Spirit, who takes away everything that estranges us from one another. May he make your church a sign of unity and an instrument of your peace among all people. And may he keep us in communion with Francis our Pope, David our Bishop, and all of your humble servants. Just as you have gathered us now at the table of your Son, so also bring us together with the glorious Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles, Thomas, and with all the saints, and yes, with our brothers and sisters and those of every race and tongue who have died in your friendship. Bring us to share with them the unending banquet of unity in a new heaven and a new earth, where the fullness of your peace will shine forth in Christ Jesus, our Lord. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen, amen. Amen. Let us rise once more, for it is at the Savior's command, informed by his divine teaching, that we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, graciously grant her peace, unity, in accordance with your will, you who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. May the peace of the Lord Jesus be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Let us share with each other a joyful sign of Christ's peace.
Thank you.
We behold Jesus, the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those now called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring us all unto everlasting life. Amen.
Please join us in singing a communion hymn, number 785, I Has Not Seen, 785, verses 1 through 3, 1, 2, and 3.
Thank you.
before we part on this beautiful day, just a couple of things very quickly to share with you. Thank you so much for the gifts that we all made to the Bishop's Appeal. Thank you so much. We've met our goal. We're over our goal. So thank you so much. A beautiful job. This week coming up, I will be meeting with someone from Catholic Charities. Catholic Charities Manitowoc at last. So that'll be a beautiful gift. I want to know what's going to happen, and so I will be in touch with you to let you know through the bulletin or here what Catholic Charities is going to do. And again, that's the local arm of Catholic Relief Service, Catholic Charities, in dioceses all over the world, if you will. So thank you so much. I was asked to ask you or to tell you this next weekend, quick trip or scrip, gas cards will be 10%, food only cards 20%. Next week, 1st to the 8th of June only. So 10% of the profit on gas cards, 20 on food cards. Just starting next weekend, okay? Marge asked me if I would share that with you. So again, if you do shop at Quick Trip, that would be a good thing. It helps our church in a beautiful way. The picnic. It seems like the wine and cheese was but a memory, and now the picnic is yet to begin. Sign-up sheets will be coming, I am sure, in particular to help. We're excited to bring the picnic back at the end of July. So please, as you see this, we'll keep you posted, but please sign up, and especially if it's a chance to meet some folks here in the parish as well. And finally, Vacation Bible School. Hard to believe, Vacation Bible School is coming this summer. Sign-up sheets are under the screen. One final note. Again, we remember the servicemen and women who passed, who died, who gave their life. I tell this story every year. My dad was assigned to a squad of 100 soldiers three times. Three times, three of them were left. Three times, three of them were left. So there's so many ways to say thank you, and I have in my life said thank you. I don't believe that was luck, or I wouldn't be here speaking to you now. So let's keep all those in our prayers. Are there young people ages 3 to 12 that would sit with me for a second at the step? You're never alone because I'm here. So I just have two things that I want to share with you on this Trinity Sunday. Just two. One, because I don't want to teach you wrong, incorrectly. One, the color to wear today is white. Not green. So I was hoping all of you didn't notice, but of course you could. So it's supposed to be white, okay? Father Dave sometimes at the end of Easter gets a little mixed up. So here we go. Tomorrow I'll wear white. Hopefully. Secondly, Trinity, three persons in one God. You've heard this before, right? An apple. Do you like apples? Right? The whole apple, the outside of the apple, I learned this in second grade. The outside of the apple, and the sisters were never wrong, the outside of the apple is the Father. The stuff that you like to eat on the inside, that's called the flesh of the apple. And then there's seeds inside, right? Little pips. That's the Holy Spirit, because if you plant them, right, you get apple trees, right? That's the Holy Spirit. Trinity. Three persons, one God. Wow, it's amazing to me. And you are amazing to me. You are welcome. Well, just don't forget, you are loved. You are loved very, very much. Okay? Thanks for coming to the step. Sacred Assembly, let us rise and let us pray. May receiving this sacrament, O Lord our God, bring us health of body and soul as we confess your eternal Holy Trinity and undivided unity through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless us all, Father, Son, Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go forth in peace. And let us pray together the St. Michael prayer. St. Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our safeguard against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the divine power of God, thrust into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
Please join us in singing 1086. This is my song, 1086.
Yeah.